you're paying for my taxi cab.
No one even rides taxis anymore.
I'm such an old soul in this body. Just kidding. Okay. She packs her stuff inside a yellow bag. She realizes this is the last with her mother.
Welcome once again to the Who Cares podcast.
Oh my God, who the hell cares?
Who cares?
What do women want? Who cares?
That's right, who the fuck cares? It's us, once again, after a 10th episode of Subba-Dubba Babba-Dubba anniversary. Finally, you're back here live and direct through a podcast, which will be released here for the listening audience, unless you're deaf, maybe it's in SAAP. But we're here live with myself, your host, Steven. That's Steven with a PH. I have a PhD. I guess I make my lady's PH balanced. I mean, the whole lot of shit has happened this week. But we are also joined here by a man, one man, that if Satan had a last name, it would be John the Fisherman. Here he is, John the Fisherman.
Thank you, Stephen. That was great. Never heard that ever before in my life. Fucking A.
I just made
that was... Shit, man.
How do you come back from that one?
It's right out of left
field. Oh, shit. And I really, to all you evangelicals out there, I apologize. We're just messing around here. I know that's blasphemous. But you know what's blasphemous? If you don't listen to John the Fisherman's podcast, it's called Action. What?
Action Packed Action. It's the greatest thing you'll ever hear. And, you shouldn't miss it. I'm making more episodes.
Well, thank God you're making more episodes, because I'm trying to make sure that we are consistent with our podcastery. I'm trying to make sure that every Wednesday, whether it be at 11 o'clock at night, whether it be 11 o'clock in the morning, but you know, on Wednesday, we will be here for you. So speaking of we will be here for you, let's transition into last week's 10th episode about diversity to be. We made it to 10 episodes. Can you fucking believe that?
No. I remember episode 2 or 3.
Right. Like, were you part... What?
I think I came on 4.
4?
I think. Okay. Yeah, I believe so.
Okay. I believe you did. And that's when you called that Carl's Jr. representative who charges too much.
Yeah. There are worse other places. Like, we went today.
Well, first of all, we went... Okay. Tell that part of the story.
It's like two 85 or some shit, like for a spicy chicken sandwich. It used to be 99 cents like a year ago.
1 year ago was 99 cents.
Yeah.
Wow.
See what happens when
inflation
and the minimum wage gets raised.
And listen, we are not saying that you minimum wage people out there are not worth in salt. Or what's the word? Worth of gold? Whatever it is.
Weight in gold.
Yeah, weight in gold. Thank you.
Yeah.
However, when you raise the minimum wage, you raise John's chicken sandwiches.
Yeah, you raise the price on everything that all the people like us fucking need.
That's right. And while we appreciate you doing that, we also appreciate you keeping the wages down so that we can eat a goddamn fucking chicken sandwich for 39 cents. What is it? 39 cents? What is this? 1872?
It was
99 cents. 99 cents.
I remember the fucking 39 cent like cheeseburger.
You did?
During the '90s. Yeah.
Really?
And it was on Wednesday or Thursday or some shit.
Your mom's like, "Hey, everybody!" Like after soccer practice, your mom's like, "Hey, everybody!" Like in fourth grade. Yeah. Hey, everybody, jump on in the van.
Fucking hamburger.
Don't worry, I got this.
Yeah. Pay like $10, feed the entire fucking van. Everybody's happy. The 90s were great, dude. No one gave a shit about anything.
No way. We had prosperity there.
Yeah. Like, the worst thing we had to worry about was AIDS, and that wasn't even that fucking bad.
Well, you know what? They told us it was bad, but yeah, you know what? Nobody really had it.
No one I fucking knew had it. Nobody I knew. I don't think it's real.
No. Well,
I don't know anybody that has it.
Well, I'm a big advocate for the...
I'm just kidding. It's fucking real. But okay. It's not real in my life.
It's not real in your life, but
it's magic in my life.
But you have a power... Well, if Satan had a last name, it would be John the Fisherman. So, AIDS can't touch your ass.
Yeah.
Well, on that topic, AIDS and Satan, let's transition to a more positive note. We wanted to make sure... What else did we do today, John the Fisherman?
We went to hypnotherapy with Ted Moreno.
That's right. I'm sorry, Ted, if we're including a little subject matter in the beginning, but maybe he can cure all that. AIDS and Satanism with hypnosis.
Yeah, you can do anything with it, I guess. He made me, like, remember his name because I can't remember anyone's fucking name.
But you know his name.
Right, his name.
So he is my hypnotherapist, and to everybody out there, Teddy Moreno is a fantastic man. He helps in a lot of things, and I'm not going to share them with you because those are private. Okay,
yeah.
For everybody out there, those are private.
Confidential.
Confidential.
Him and him.
That's right.
South Pasadena.
What up? Fucking Fremont.
Represent.
Fremont Huntington.
Yeah, Fremont straight.
Oh shit. But no, we went there today, and this was John's first trip to there. I thought, you know what, America and now the United Kingdom, who was also listening to us, and Japan,
mm-hmm.
Japan, which I've been there. I've been to Harajuku, Shinoba. That's been a little bit, but I did stay there, and there was a it's weird because in Japan they have Seven Holdings. Did you know that? It's not 7-Eleven. It's owned by 7-Eleven, but it's called Seven Holdings.
Wow.
Because it's probably the parent company or something. But what they have is they have like crabs and instead of hot dogs and shit, they got deep fried crabs. And
what?
Swear to God, it's weird shit.
That's fucking awesome.
It is awesome because I would jog a yog.
Yeah.
Just kidding. No, I'm just kidding. I would jog through the little streets there wherever we were staying at because we stay with a family.
Mm-hmm.
Who me and my girlfriend at the time did not have sex because they have paper walls, even in apartments. That's crazy. But,
crazy.
Right. So I would jog in the morning, and I would go to Seven Holdings, which is it's owned by 7-Eleven. And then instead of hot dogs, all the crap, there you go. You want to pull a live crab out of there? You want to
eat some? Yeah,
or a fried crab. I don't know about live crab, but is it like a crab on a stick?
Dude, like, the only crab I know is artificial crab.
Oh my goodness.
I don't fucking. I mean, I've had, like, the crab legs.
Get the fuck out of here.
Have you, crab legs are bomb.
Have you been to... Right here.
Crab cooker?
No, crab cooker is pretty good. No, the greatest crab legs
I've
in the area.
Some things.
The greatest crab in the area. Or on the planet, I think, that I've ever had. Captain Jack's right here. And Captain Jack's, if you're listening, become a sponsor. Because I'm giving you major love right now. Captain Jack's gives you crab legs about this size. And they've already dug it out for you. So you don't have to crack nothing.
Oh, nice.
And so you just have the meat. You just kind of just... It is a little pricey.
Yeah.
But it is the most delicious crab like on the planet.
Hmm.
We got to go maybe after this podcast, I think, if they're still open. They should stay open. And they also have an amazing shrimp potato skins only served in the bar. It's like the most... And the cheese with the crab... Oh, it's a crab shrimp potato skins and you get to... At the bottom of the pan, you get to dig the crab, that you know, that cheese that's burnt around it, and you get to dig with that crab and that shrimp, and it come together. It's like, it's pussy juice.
Mm.
Well, sorry for being so obscene right now, but I guess we got off on a tangent. Let's get back to Ted Moreno. John, what were your thoughts? This first time, you know, I know you interviewed him last week,
mm-hmm.
but now you actually got the essence. And the hypnosis, how'd you feel like it?
I felt like I just woke up, really. Like, I don't know. Like, you kind of go into this half-sleep, half-awake state. And like, you just go, like, deeper and deeper into the state, and you're about to fall asleep, and he brings you back out of it, and he's, like, telling you stuff, and it kind of, like, sticks in your head.
We're taking a trip back to last week episode.
Oh, right.
So
right.
What we're trying to say is we're taking a trip back to last week's episode, and to kind of put a bow around it and kind of tuck it into bed. Yeah. And kind of put it, you know, let everybody know, thank you for listening last week. But we wanted to put our money where our mouth was. So John the Fisherman, yes, he did interview him, but he also today got to experience it. And
yeah, like, it, I don't know, I just feel calmer, peacefuler, like, worked on some things that, kind of personal.
Absolutely.
That was it. I just feel good about things.
And that's beautiful. I think that sums it up right there. And, it's not magic, it's not nothing, but, let's give a shout out to TedMoreno.com. You can listen to a couple free things. I think it has some MP3s you can listen to on there or whatnot.
And you get a recording of the things. So you, like, he wants you to listen to it for like a week after.
Oh, that's right. So a week after, you have it.
A whole week.
He puts it in your voice notes.
Yeah. And then he said, like, listen to it every day for the next week.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
But he doesn't, like, erase it out of your voice memos.
No. No, it's still there.
Oh yeah, so he records everything that he does,
yeah.
So you have it there for yourself. Yeah. So those are gems of knowledge that you need to listen to every day and remind yourself. Because you know, it's like building a muscle. You don't go to the gym one day, all of a sudden you're gigantic. You're like the Rock or some of that, right? You have to build that muscle daily, you know. So it's not overnight, but we do highly suggest them, and we thank you for listening. If you haven't listened to last week's, I think it'd be very insightful because these two idiots and Megan, who is conveniently absent today, I guess, you know, I guess she's must be part of the Me Too movement today. Is that what's going on?
That would be like a good answer, I think. Probably a better answer than reality.
I know. You know. But she's going to school.
Yeah, it's probably school. It's all school's fault. Stupid school.
Well, she's trying to be a nurse.
It's all that one dude's fault.
Oh, yeah, the idiot. Well, yeah. And that's probably, you know what? If she only had Ted Moreno, she would be flying high.
Yeah,
she'd be flying. And the problem, no, for reals, the problem is that one dude, and this is to America out there, one person in your life can really affect your ability to affect a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
And that is, unfortunately, what's happened to Megan? Was supposed to be a nurse 5 or 6 years ago, but one dude, or maybe not even that, maybe a little less than that. But she is such a happy, and I know everybody. I read your emails. I know you guys think how great she is. She's such a happy, happy soul, and she makes everybody else around her happy. And so to deprive America of that. To deprive 89-year-old men that might be having their last days in the hospital, or might be just like my dad working on his knee, and he loved his nurses just because he had knee surgery, but those nurses were fantastic to him.
Yeah,
a big shout out to PIH Presbyterian Hospital. I'm sure that they're not probably too happy with the beginning of this conversation, but this part of the conversation, I hope they listen to. You guys did my dad very well. And you guys gave him the care that he needed, every one of you there. And I want to say we will definitely hashtag it or something, or make sure that you guys get this episode, because Presbyterian Hospital, thank you. You guys really cared about my dad's knee surgery. And you know what? Megan could have been caring about my dad's surgery, but you know what? She had a negative person in her life who still seems to keep creeping around. But
she's still making forward strides.
We can't ever not discount that, you know. She's trying to make bust free. And for everybody out there, if there's one person that's really making you negative, it's not the negative person's fault, really. They're just negative. It's your fault for not really seeing it. It's your fault for not really seeing it, because I mean, in the beginning we all get kind of like caught up in things or whatnot, but it, you know, after a while, like, what am I doing? Like, I know this person's bringing me down.
Yeah.
So, and that one person could affect everything in your whole fucking life.
Yeah. You know those moments of clarity when you're like, what the fuck, man? Like, this is not my life. Fuck. Listen to that shit.
Listen to it. Because that is, that's your inner, whatever it is. Inner.
It's your inner self screaming for fucking help.
Exactly. So, enough existentialism, enough philosophicalism. Let's get down. We don't have a guest this week, unfortunately, because of a variety of things. We started school. Mm-hmm. I know, yes. And tomorrow we will be in front of 40 to 50 people presenting a pitch deck. And to anybody out there that wants to know what a pitch deck is, you go ahead and email both of us. You can email John at whatstheplay.net or Steven at whatstheplay.net. And if you want to become an entrepreneur, maybe we could help you out on a little bit of things that might get you pushed towards the goal that you want to set. So tomorrow we're doing about in front of 35, 45 people. Mm-hmm. And then on Friday, a bunch of a group of people as well. We're supposed to be doing this pitch deck. So this is a busy week for us. So we apologize that we haven't had the time to get a guest. But yeah, we came up with something much, much better. Much, much better. And it's going to be in about 5 minutes. It's going to be the Q&A because we're going to read everybody's emails that you have written us. And I think half of them are just completely, you just want to see how fucking stupid we are, or you just want to troll us, or you just want to just get us crazy. But we're going to answer, try and answer a very, very, very great amount of them. So before we go into that, John, we do have something very fantastic this week that just happened. We do have a mobile application available for the public.
Stack Up and High Jump. Those are two different apps. They're simple little games. They're pretty addictive. At least Stack Up. High Jump, I still haven't figured out yet. But
you haven't figured out High Jump? Oh, you own the game?
Please do tell me, because I'm trying to understand it.
Well, they're available right now only on the Google Play Store.
Yeah.
Right?
When I was looking through the source code, though, it had some like iOS stuff, so I need to look into that and ask the guy.
Wow, and how wonderful is that? Well, here we are sharing the background. You're kind of getting the behind-the-scenes look at the background of what we do behind the scenes. Mm-hmm. Talking about source coding. Mm-hmm. Right. So to everybody out there, please download the game Stack Up. It's it says Think LLC, which is the parent company for all of this, for our podcast, for our mobile application that we'll be coming out this year called What's the Play. And but right now, the one that's available, it's called Stack Up. It's very simple. It's very fun. You want to describe it a little bit, maybe?
You're this little dude that stands there, and when you press the screen, he jumps, and you jump up. You have these like platforms coming at you from different directions, kind of, and you jump onto the platforms and jump higher and higher and higher.
So right now, to anybody out there who gets
100,
how much are we giving them?
Believe it's $25.
So if you have a PayPal account, we'll shoot $25. And if you get to 200, is that impossible?
I'm sure it's possible, but
the first one to reach 100 is $25. The first one to get 200 gets $100.
Okay, yeah.
That's perfect. Yeah. We'll put in your PayPal account.
And you have to show us a screenshot, and
we can see it, right?
We need to be able to see the whole thing, because you are able to save videos. So save the video of it, at least of whatever it does save of your journey. Save that.
Okay, so save that. Save your journey up to when you're right there. So that would be fantastic for us. You can just email us at info@whatstheplay.net. And just to let you know, it has now been downloaded in how many amazing amount of countries. We're at 20,000 downloads. Did you know India really liked this game? Who knew India would love this game? And to India, we say we love you. And if we had, the India word for Stack Up. But there's so many dialects in India.
Yeah.
So you really can't do that. But I bet I could pull up. So, anyways, let's get off that topic. So Stack Up the Game. It is on your Google Play store. Google Play Store.
Yeah.
Just go ahead and grab that. There's also a game called High Jump, and we'd love for you to figure that one out, because I guess our own creator. Yeah. All right, well, just download both of them, please, and support us. And if you screenshot it and you send it to us, we will definitely send you a T-shirt, a What's the Play T-shirt, in the very least. Thank you for supporting us. So it's john@whatstheplay.net. Any questions about the gaming, any sort of problems that you're having, you're wondering why you didn't get the 25 because somebody beat you, but nobody yet has achieved 100. And we're talking to you people in Mumbai. And you know who else downloaded it?
I'm going to try to get 100.
Oh, God. You're going to try to get 100?
Yeah.
You've had a lot of time.
I want 25 bucks. I've gotten to 24. That's as far as
I'm That'd be going. Terrible if you won it. I would be so upset if you won it. I'd be so pissed. Somebody beat this motherfucker's ass, please, and not let. That's the key. Do not let John the Fisherman get
the money. Because I need money. Prove that you need it more than me.
Oh shit! Well, we do miss the Southern Belle, Miss Megan, you can get her T-shirt at whatstheplay.net, 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 and see exactly what we'd be unleashing on you guys, because I really think we're here to help America, and I promise you, it will help you in your daily life, it will help you in your spiritual life, it'll help you in your physical life, it'll help you all across the board, because what we're trying to do here is help you, and I'm not saying that sarcastically. This time, for once, I'm being very, very serious. We will be able to help you. So let's go on to another topic here. John says we don't have a special guest. We decided to do what?
Q&A.
So we're supposed to do a Q&A, right? So all the questions that have been sent in to us, John had to sift through emails. And a lot of the emails had different titles on them. They had different whatever. It was very difficult to sift through the emails for John because...
Yeah, we need you to put in the subject line that it's a question or that Stephen needs to respond to it, or question for Stephen. That's perfect.
Question for Stephen in the subject line, because with all the emails and we don't want to sound like we're, oh, God, but we have a lot of emails coming through there for different reasons.
And a lot of stuff goes to spam. Exactly. So it's a lot easier to pick up.
Absolutely. So we don't want to miss any of your questions. So we want to answer all the ones today as best we can. And I'm saying as best we can because we just want to put a disclaimer out. I am not a certified anything. Oh, actually, I'm a certified minister. So what does that mean?
You're a minister.
I am a minister. And for anybody that needs me, I am a minister 100%, and I will marry you. I've done four weddings. Three of them liked it. One of them went really bad. Anyways, John, what are the questions, the Q&A? I guess we've been talking for too much. Now it's time for you to ask the questions. I have not seen these questions. John has written them down. I do not have any idea what he is talking about, and I've made sure that I don't know, because we're just going to have to go with it. Mm-hmm. Oh, God, here's
a smile. These are all good ones.
Okay.
This one is from a Robert Blade from Austin, Texas. Yeah, Robert Blade.
You had to start.
Know what his email address started with? I'm not going to do the app. Not the app part.
I'm pretty sure you're not supposed to share their last name, really.
I have to.
Because his last name is Blade? Yeah. I mean, you started with a fucking, oh my God. Well, to everybody out there, we will not share your last name. I guess just, if you have a name that John wants to share, I guess he probably will.
I don't think it's his real last name. But
okay, all right.
That's
probably true.
If it is your real last name, sorry.
Sorry, Robert Blade. I hope it's not a very personal question.
No.
Okay.
It's just what got you into wanting to be in the internettainment industry?
Hmm. What wanted me to get into it?
What got you to want to be
a... Well, I originally, let me just tell everybody out there, originally I did not want to be a focal point or a face of anything. However, we do have a mobile application coming out entitled What's the Play? And to create brand awareness, and this is honest truth, to create brand awareness, but also we found out that people actually kind of dug it, and they kind of understood that each one of us that are a part of this company, John's the president, I'm the chairman, and Anthony Jackson one day will have his podcast come out. But we're all a bunch of characters, and I kind of had the idea that we should have all been kind of like a Daft Punk, like we all wear masks and mm-hmm. be behind the scenes. That was my idea because I didn't want anything to be bigger than the brand. However, we also need to let the world know exactly who we are. And What's the Play is basically an opinion and advice forum of some sense. And that will be... you'll be seeing that coming out pretty soon, but mm-hmm. we're going to be unleashing that when we unleash it, possibly just a hint in 2 weeks. So on Wednesday, we don't want to mess up your Valentine's Day. We'll be out actually talking to the girls that don't have Valentine's at that day, and then we just clean up. But mm-hmm. what I'm saying is that the reason why I wanted to get into this is more of a must than more of a need than a really a want. Because I don't want to be anything. I am who I am, and if everybody doesn't like it, fuck them. So either they want to come aboard, they want to listen, then great. But we have a brand that we want to, and we have personalities. And I think that if not us, then who? If you guys want to take it on, go okay. for it. But I think that we actually have some knowledge of some sense because we are a little bit older. Then I'm not in my 20s anymore. I'm in my early 30s. And so now that we're able to do this, I think that it's, I know I'm going on very long on this, but mm-hmm. I think that it's time for us to really be honest. And transparency is everything in this world. So let's move forward and show you who we are, fucking warts and all. So that's how I got into the entertainment industry.
Yeah, it was a hard word to say.
I know.
I think you made it up.
Robert Blade, thank you for listening.
Yeah. All right. This one is from Jessica.
Jessica?
From New Hampshire. Neshua, New Hampshire.
Dude, there's a new shoe?
Neshua.
Get the fuck out of here.
Yeah.
Well.
Cool sounding town.
That is a cool
whatever
sound.
Whatever it is.
I hope she has older shoes, ass.
You seem like the artist type. Do you take on other people's energy or emotions that of people around you at times? Like when people are sad, do you feel it and want to butter them up, do a little dance?
Absolutely, I take on everybody's emotions, and I think that that's sometimes a gift and a downfall too at the same time. I think that I really truly feel only for people I care about, or that I think that I wouldn't even say that. I do take on if somebody's really upset or sad, it's in human nature. If you're not a fucking cyborg or a serial killer, you do take on people's emotions, but I'm not fake. And I will not like try to do a happy dance because of it. I try to ask them why and see what it is. Why? Because if they're just acting sad because they got a headache or because they're hungover or because their boyfriend left them or if, what's her name? What's her name?
Jessica.
Jessica. Yeah, Jessica. I truly think that if you take on everybody's emotions, it could paralyze you. So you got to understand you can be sympathetic. But at the same time, empathy in some sense is the root of all evil, I feel. Because when you take on empathy, that means that you're taking on their problems. And it stumps you from being the better person that you are. And so I truly, truly feel that like I want to help everybody I want to help everybody. And I think you do too, John. I mean, mm-hmm. right? I mean, we would. I mean, if we could.
Yeah.
But we also can't let people's ideas of what they need to be, how they need to be helped or whatnot, mm-hmm. truly take over our lives.
Right.
Because yeah. that just creates, it'll wear us down. It'll yeah. be like an anchor on our shoulders.
Right. There's a difference between helping and living your life around that person.
Exactly. Exactly. And so empathy in some sense is I feel, the root of all evil. And if anybody wants to discuss that with me, Stephen@whatstoplay.net. So, but truly, I do, Jessica, I do truly, I want everybody around me to succeed. And nobody's bigger than anybody, and myself included. I mean, who cares? As long as we all go together as a group unit to see people strive and make fantastic strides in their life, and to see them actually grow as a human being, man, what more can you get? That's success right there.
There you go. And she asked this as well, like...
oh, shit. This is a two-part question?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ, Jessica.
And if I'm correct about you being an artist, what type of art do you do?
Oh, for being an artist. Yeah, I guess that comes with being an artist, because I think sometimes I think of myself probably first as an artist, and it's difficult to be sometimes a businessman, because you have to be... you have to be absolute... And you can't let emotion, you have to let logic, you know, run its course. So artist probably runs through both of our veins, correct? Mm-hmm. And that's a two-pronged approach that it's difficult to balance. So I think that what kind of artist would I be? I'd definitely be a musical artist, because obviously it's so cliche, but music is a soundtrack to our lives. And I think the only time I've ever fully felt peace in my life is singing in front of people, whether it be one person or whether it be, you know, 1,000 people. That's the only time I've truly felt at peace. I'm awesome. A terrible painter. Are you a good painter?
I don't know. I've never really tried it.
See? But you're a complete artist. Just you looking at you, you're a complete artist. Everything about you is art.
Probably.
It is. 100%.
You're probably right.
Did I just make you cry?
No.
Okay.
Sorry, I'm just like
I'm just being honest, man. Like, look at these people. Thank you very much to everybody that's emailing us, because you're bringing the best out of us, John. This is fantastic.
All right, this is kind of a silly one.
Uh-huh.
From Sam.
Oh, Sam. Is he trying to troll us?
Kind of. I just thought it was really funny, so I wanted to ask. It's from Lake Charles, Louisiana.
Lake Charles, Louisiana. Where the hell is Lake Charles? And no offense against Lake Charles.
Yeah, I don't know where it is either. God's but have you ever smacked a girl's ass and found out it was your sister?
Well, no. I honestly have smacked many girls' ass, but I am an only child. So, Sam,
does not apply,
does
Sam.
Not, yeah, does. Actually, that question might apply to you, John. You do have a sister.
No, that hasn't.
Okay. You do have a sister around the same age? I don't know.
Yeah, no.
But you guys have never been around each other in a weird way.
No, never been at the same place, not known it, and then...
See, I don't know. I wish I had an older sister. I really do. Because she would have brought her older friends over, and...
Yeah, did would she?
No.
No,
she'd probably be a bitch. Nerd. She'd say, that guy's just a little kid, don't stay away from him.
Yeah, pretty much. He's just a little dweeb.
Right. Right. And okay. But you know what, though? I bet
they all wanted to. Where is she hiding?
They all wanted to, but they didn't want to piss off your sister.
Yeah.
That's fucked up. You're right.
Yeah, she fucked up.
So, I feel sorry, but I feel... If you had a cool older sister that was just a complete whore that didn't give a fuck,
then
that's a badass dude out there.
Yeah, game on. You get the breath of Satan fucking in you, and like, you're like, fuck, dude, I'm not going to piss that chick off.
Never.
That's what happened.
Oh, man. I'd like a sister like that. Just a complete whore of a sister. Older sister. When older I was younger. Sister. Or when I was older, maybe a younger one.
I'd probably want a younger one. Fuck with her.
Right, that's what I meant. Beat the shit out of her. Right. But if she wants, she can be a pristine princess. But if she wants to hang out with whore friends, mm-hmm. by all means.
Yeah, she can do all that. She can do whatever she wants.
She can have summer parties, all whatever she wants to do.
But she invites me to the parties.
Yeah. And she won't invite you to the parties because you'd be like, hey, what you doing over there? Is that a cake stand you're doing?
Awesome. Let me hold up one of your fucking cakes. Like, whatever you're doing.
And like any dude, just like, hey. I'll
help you out.
Like three dudes knocked out from John
the
Fisher.
Who the fuck? Eyes up here. Bud.
Eyes up here. Up here. Oh, shit. These questions are fucking fantastic, John. I'm glad you were able to sift through them, even though they didn't put a question for Steven.
Yeah, no. It's fucking, some of them are blank. And,
right. It's tedious.
No, it was just because I went through so many emails and just fucking...
I know. Can we... These are some great questions you've selected, though,
this
John.
This is from Little Jimmy from Sue.
Wait. His name is not Little Jimmy.
It says Little Jimmy. Savunga, Alaska.
Wait, what?
I don't know how
Where the fuck are you getting these?
Dude, they're fucking emails that come
from
to
Savunga. Are you sure
Either
that's how you say
Savunga or Savunga. Savunga?
Oh, maybe it's from an Indian reservation.
I don't know.
Does he want us to open a casino over there?
Apparently he doesn't know much.
Oh, Jesus.
Where do babies come from?
Well, of course. We all know where they come from.
The stork.
No.
Walmart.
No.
Amazon.
They come from a man's tears.
Watermelon seed.
Because he didn't know. He didn't know what he was getting into. And then.
Sounds about real enough.
Yep. So babies are actually made from man's tears.
Okay, next question. All right, this one's from Bob.
What?
And it says, from Utaho, Idaho.
That's fucking great. Bob.
Bob.
Bob, you already got me a Bob.
What's with the suits?
Ooh, what's with the suits? Like, I think I'm a badass.
Yeah, what's with the suits?
Well, you know what suits do? I love, really, to the 50s, they would have called me a dandy. Someone who dresses sharp, has a sharp tongue, and a sharp wit.
That's what a dandy is?
Well, yeah. Dandy is like a dress very impeccably. Mm. Handkerchief.
Fucking shiny stuff.
Yeah, that kind of stuff. I actually absolutely love English suits, tie and loafers. I mean, French sunglasses,
vests,
and I do love my vest. But let's just tell Bob that if you want to come to What's the Play, you can dress like that too. And if you don't want to, you can dress however you want to, because I do not discriminate, because John, you're wearing a shirt right now that says Wet Dreams.
Mm-hmm.
Dummies. No, what does it say? Oh, Wet Dreams. Oh, it's a Growlers. Oh, it's a Growlers t-shirt. It says Wet Dreams. Oh, perfect. Summer of 2016. Perfect. And I love individuality. And I feel like I don't wear, you know, I don't just wear suits just to be a suit guy. I didn't go to Men's Warehouse.
Mm-hmm.
I bought some suits that I think express my individuality.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to be that guy that says, hey, I got this suit. It looks a little too big. Yeah, I guess I'm in the wedding. I guess I'm one of the groomsmen and it doesn't fit me real well.
Yeah.
You buy a suit that fits you because it feels fresh, feels crisp. I love the way a suit looks. If it's done right with a little flair, a little panache, it's fucking badass. That's my opinion. Mm-hmm. Bab.
Bab. Maybe you don't know how to use suits right. Bad. From Utaho, Idaho.
You're fucking... Our, dude, our...
You suck, Bob.
Our listenership is unbelievable.
Oh yeah, they're characters and so
they are. We might get, we, maybe the one that has the best question today.
They gotta be a special guest.
That's what I'm thinking.
All right, we'll see. You'll have to choose then.
That's America chooses.
Yeah. All right, cool. Everyone choose. Let us know. Info at westplay.net.
Yeah, which one do you like the best? We'll have, maybe it's Bab. And they'll call in from fucking Idaho, Udo.
This one, the email will say in the subject, vote.
Oh, right. Vote. Right,
like gotcha. The
title and the subject matter.
Yeah, the question vote. Or something. I don't know. The vote.
Yeah, the vote.
The vote. Yeah.
Or should we put it on our Twitter?
Yeah, they're on your Twitter. It's a Twitter
thing. Because we were thinking of changing the name from Who Cares, but it seems like a lot of work right now with everything we're doing.
Yeah. People don't want to have to click somewhere else.
Yeah. You know what? We're the best Who Cares podcast. If there's other Who Cares podcasts out there, fuck those guys.
Yeah, they all suck. Right. So this is from Tong Song.
What from, Tong? Wait, from what? You're not
one Hong Kong.
No way. Are you imitating an Asian accent as trying to say his name, or is that how you're trying to say it? The proper term.
I'm trying to say it right.
Oh, okay.
Pay respect.
You're very respectful with that.
How you grow up? Where? What? Why? What you do now for a living?
Oh my God. You're being so respectful up until then. To all our Chinese audience,
That's how he wrote it.
Let's respect him. Because if I were to talk in Mandarin or Cantonese, I would sound like a goddamn idiot.
Sound like an idiot.
I would sound completely stupid.
Yeah.
So we want to address this. Thank you for listening to us. We're actually, that's interesting that you say this, John. Because whatstheplay.net will be available in China. You know what's not available in China?
A lot of things.
Yes.
The internet.
Reddit.
Yeah.
eBay.
Facebook. And Amazon.
I'm not sure about Facebook.
No, Facebook's allowed, I think.
Yeah. And then Amazon. We've gotten clearance. We are going to China. Whatstheplay.net will be in China. So in the next 2 weeks...
Different URL,
definitely, because we have to conform to the Chinese policies and rules. We do not want to upset the People's Republic of China, because we want to help the people of China, like this gentleman right here, but we have to do it under the rules of the People's Republic, and we respect them, very much so. I don't know why I'm making this motion.
Yeah, you can't do that.
So, what's the question again? I'm sorry. How, don't say it like you're...
What Chinese. Was growing up like?
Okay, growing up, I was the only child. I had a fantastic childhood. And a couple of things got in the way. There was a basketball coach that, unfortunately, his wife left him for another woman. His name was Mike Murphy at Sonora. And he didn't want to... he didn't think we won state championship in junior high. And for some reason, because I had bleached hair and striped socks, he didn't want to bring me along the ride. And that really pissed me off. So I say to you, Mike Murphy, I'm sorry that your wife left you for another woman, but you hadn't been fucking her the right way. So anyways, in saying that, that kind of stuff kind of jaded me for a little bit. And then, you know what happened? You know what happened, John?
What happened?
I grew up. And I said, well, who gives a fuck about that kind of shit? Like, is anybody going pro? And ain't nobody going pro out of our high school. And everybody took it so, looking back, everybody took it so serious.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, you grow up and I may have faltered for a little bit, you know, as a kid, you know, you grow up and.
Yeah.
So to everybody out there, even if you're going through hard times and you think that it's the most horrible thing in your life, you think people are talking about you in this school and you got to move schools, but unfortunately social media follows you and tells you, you can't, you know, you're a fucking whore, you're a slut, or you're a piece of shit guy, or you're an asshole or all that. You know what? Give it 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. They either will be dead because they're such fucking idiots, because their dumbiness will get them killed, or nobody gives a fuck what they say. just give it time. You will be better, and you will be your life will be better, because like really nothing matters after about the age of like 19, 20, something like that. You just move on, and you meet new people. There are so many exciting people in the world. John, I didn't meet you until I was, what, 30? And you were like a good young 23 or 24 or something like that.
Yeah,
right. So, I mean, we didn't meet each other until later on in life. Mm-hmm. And now he's like a brother to me. And, you know, I don't care what he went through or what I went through. All that matters is there's a connection, and not that kind of connection, but a real, like an idea connection, and intelligence. And a drive and a passion, and you'll get through all that. Like, who gives a fuck? Just move on, make yourself great, and anybody that tries to take you down, fuck them. And to Wang Zhongjing, whatever his name is,
Tong Sung,
that's my life story. I made it. I was very wealthy by the age of 28. Then I decided I picked my bootstraps up, and now we're ready to rock and roll. Mm-hmm. And now that's why you're listening to me. So I went from the gutter to the high rise, back down to the gutter, and now we're at the, not the high rise, but the middle house.
Yeah, the middle house,
but we're still here in beautiful Huntington Beach, California. Yeah. And we do have a segment about Ted, the landlord, not to be confused with Ted Moreno. Ted Moreno is an amazing man. We have two Teds in our life. Yeah, one's an amazing man, Landlord Ted is a piece of garbage.
Yeah,
he's amazingly a piece of garbage. It's just because he's old doesn't mean that he's not garbage. He was garbage back when he was 20.
He's not a respectable person.
He doesn't deserve respect. You would think at that age you would start to learn about it.
You would be wise in shit. But I know people that are like 20 that are wiser than his
this
ass.
Guy, right?
Yeah, he thinks he's so fucking smart too.
And he gets knocked down at every turn.
Fucking every time someone deals with him, boom.
We like, hate
this shit's fucked up. Like, how could you let it get like this?
Right. So that's coming to the next segment. So just you wait. It's pretty funny. We're going to have
Fucko Corner.
No, I'm kidding. Oh, shit. No, but for real, though, it's going to be hopefully maybe a weekly segment, because every week it's something pretty hilarious.
Like 10 minutes with Ted, Landlord Ted.
Right. And we're only going to be here for, I don't know, we've been here a couple months. You know, we moved from our other house, and we've been here, and we're probably here a couple months, and, you know, restructuring things and whatnot, and we'll move on. But this guy is just a piece of work. And the problem is that I was a landlord of 90 people when I was 20 fucking 5 years old. Mm-hmm. And of like tenements in Grape Street and Hickory, down in whatever. I used to have tenants calling me. They said, Steven, I can't sit in the front room. I go, what is it now, Teresa? God, you're calling me for everything, aren't you? And she goes, no, well, bullets are actually coming through my window. And I said, oh. Well, that might be an issue. Yeah. So when this comes and complains about some like plumbing issues, shut the fuck up. I don't care how old you are, because the way he treats me is not how an old man. I don't deserve to be treated like that.
Yeah.
He said I have young men coming over here, and I said, "Hold on, Ted. Hold on. John works here. Don't you be insinuating nothing here."
Yeah, I fucking. Just because I bust my ass here doesn't mean
you bust your ass here.
You know, like I work.
Absolutely. Fucking idiot. Any more questions?
You know, I don't know. I don't think we have any more time for it.
Really?
Yeah, just because we're running out of time.
Oh, it's been a fantastic episode. Yeah. All right. You know what? I think you're right. I think we should just end it here. So you know what, John? It's been a pleasure.
It's always a pleasure, man. I always have a good time when I'm here, and let's keep it coming.
Let's keep it coming, and by keeping it coming, when is your next episode? You have to give everybody
a definite date. Will be not this Friday, but the next one. I promise.
One Friday away.
Yeah.
Okay, and then will you be consistent with it? Because the people got to know.
Yes.
The people will know.
There's so much action to be packed into action that it can be weekly.
There is so much action. And I know you've got a lot of things like that. I know you've been working on it. Like the reason being is because this Who Cares podcast is kind of, you know, the spur of the moment. Mm. Or not spur of the moment. We do put a lot into the pre-production.
Yeah.
But John actually takes a lot of time. He's a what you call a perfectionist.
Yeah, I can't. I'm never happy with my
production. Never happy. He's so unhappy with his stuff that he doesn't want to release it. But I said, John, you just got to release your action-packed action because you need more action, pack more action into it.
It's not enough yet. Yeah, it'll be ready.
It'll be ready. So it will be ready. On that note.
It will be ready. Bye-bye.
Was in my eyes. Nobody's gonna save my life. Over and over, is it really over? I don't wanna see you. boy I once was in my eyes.